There's a race for a place in the grand finale. In the end, Jungle Chef Paul was ejected from the jungle.
The celebrity going home tonight is...
And Paul joins us now live. Paul, what a final three. I mean, it was always going to be a huge shock at some stage, but we were all shocked to see you get ejected last night. Were you bummed to just miss out on the on going to the finale?
Yes and no. I think I went for the full gamut of experiences in terms of, you know, fondling the danger noodles and then getting ejected. I can say I've done it all. And really, that was the last kind of little event. And then it's the finale. So I didn't really get to miss out on too much, which I always see things as half glass full. You know, that's me.
Yeah. But you were the centre of the show's biggest twist this year.
Twist.
Yeah, you had to maintain the fib that the David, the fake celebrity, was a real celebrity. Now, I understand, was that really challenging? Because you spend every single day with these guys in the jungle. You've got this really big bond with them. Did you have a strategy?
Yeah, like mine was just to keep it very low-key because I had my eye on whatever the reward was going to be. And I quite, like, enjoyed being allowed to just blank face light. But I didn't really have to do much, you know. David was very self-sufficient, being a celebrity, and I think it was only when others came into the fray, that being Joey and Davina, that the tales started to get more and more outlandish, and that's when I started to get a little bit concerned. People like Leonardo DiCaprio and Elton John started to get into the mix, and I was like, whoa, guys, like rein it in.
That must be the hardest part when you come in first and you're meeting people who you've never met before.
Yeah.
And you kind of have to start off with a lie, I guess. We never know who's lying anywhere. We have our own Tash Exelby here, and we don't know if she's lying or not because she's saying that you're coming up with a big relationship now online. Yeah. Tash, you've been put on the spot here.
Yep, go on.
I have never met this person before. I don't know who she is.
Hey.
Are
you ready to tell the truth or should I? Because I've got, you know what? I'm a journalist. I'm catching you out on these lies.
Okay, Excuse me. Screenshot.
Yes, fine. It was me who slid into your DMs first. I know. But look at this, Australia, right? We're texting. And we're loving it. And then Poe, she's stepping it up
voice
to the
messages.
Voice messages. And we're going back and forth. And ladies and gentlemen,
Tuesday morning.
Oh, that was happening late on a Saturday night. So I'm just saying, you know, Po says she's single, but maybe she might not be forever. That's taking it too far. But hey. Po, we are friends, right?
Guys, I need you to take this offline, all right? Paul, we've only got a little bit of time with you, and I want to get to the good stuff here. And Tash is getting a bit creepy there as well.
It was
only natural, I guess, that you were going to be the camp cook in there. But how is it for you when it comes to, like, those Tucker trials that you had to do? You know, because obviously you have to have the palate for a lot of strange foods.
Yeah, interesting you say that because that was actually one of my biggest fears. And I'm not actually super adventurous with food, as you might expect me to be. And having said that, I will let you know that a turkey testicle mainly tastes like turkey. It's really just the textural element that's challenging.
I didn't mind. I ate a turkey testicle last year and I actually didn't mind it.
Willingly?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, in one of the eating trials.
Oh.
I when I was in the jungle. No, not like yesterday when I was at a farm.
It's like, how is Nom?
Yeah, no. But I didn't mind it. Do you think that you might be able to use turkey testicles in your future cuisines, Poe?
Not so much. Okay. I mean, you could hide it in a tureen or something.
Yeah.
The cross section would be interesting, wouldn't it?
Good, yeah. It's this Sunday night, grand finale. We don't like putting you on the spot, but we're going to. Who do you reckon's going to win?
I have a big inkling that it's going to be the two entertainers. So I think Dylan and Brookie.
Wow. Oh, fantastic. If you had the chance, Paul, would you do it all again?
I think I actually would.
Yeah.
Oh, good. That's what we want to hear.
Oh, it's good.
And what an artist. All the things we're finding out about you as well.
Yeah.
Drawing Beau Ryan one of your French girls. That was great.
Look, it's so nice. And the universe works in very mysterious ways because
yes,
her
does.
And Tash could be and a lifelong
well.
Love couple if
well, that's
she
it.
Doesn't run fast enough.
Do you know what, Paul? We loved before you went into the jungle. We love you even more now.
Yeah.
And thanks for joining us today. The grand finale is live Sunday night at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. To vote for your celebrity you want to win, head to 10play.com.au/vote. It's a live finale. Paul, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me, guys.
Of course.